Hello, everyone. How's it going? Dr. Incompetent here, and let's play some Satisfactory, shall we? Well, I'm at my base. We're near enough, right? There's my space elevator, and way down here we have our facility. We've been working on bringing power over, as well as a conveyance system back to our base from our crystal mining project. Now, mercifully, I believe it was Dylan who may have showed me this. I'm not entirely sure, but I've left notes for myself, which is very helpful in a game of this scope that I don't play every day, so I can remember what to do. And you can see over in the right margin, get crystal mining done. Right, so if I push escape, and I think you can, or not escape, but if you, let's say you push tab, and then you can mouse over here, and then you can click over here and change your to-do list. So anyway, we got crystal mining that we need to do, okay? And so this means getting this stuff all the way to our base. It's not there yet. Now, this is a conveyor belt Mark 1, which is what we have here. I'm not wealthy enough to get a different conveyor belt, and so, you know, I'm fine with that. I think what I might do is just lift this up right here. So what we'll do is we will go to queue, and we're going to create a logistics conveyor lift. This is 60 resources a minute, and the nice thing is I can just upgrade this later, you know, if I really want to, if I get a better one, and that's probably what I will do. I'm going to raise this up, and we're going to have it spit out kind of up there, and I'm fine with that. Then what we're going to do is just go into this conveyor belt and connect it to the input of this, and then we need to get to the output over there, which we can do beautifully. Wrong button. Oh my god. Oh dear lord. By using my jump station. And I'm going to jump it. I have some work to go back. I need to get mushrooms from the cave. And we'll do that. Look at that jump. God, that was beautiful. I'm really excited to play this game. The only problem I really have is I have so much work to do. It's kind of mind-numbing, but it's going to be really, really fun if we can get it done. Oh, I didn't make this tall enough. I thought this was easily big enough. Can I get up here? Yeah, okay. With the clipping monster, I know some of you guys who are not used to these. I was talking to people on stream about this. If you're not used to the later updates, which I never played previously to 5, so I don't know. But the clipping thing wasn't possible. And so you're seeing some, like, really twisted science. Alright. So we're going to have crystal coming in here. My conveyor belts are just running through each other willy-nilly. There are no problems. Don't worry about it. I am more concerned with functionality at this point then aesthetics, and then I will be more concerned with optimization, efficiency, maximum output next, and then eventually maybe, oh god, some kind of here, stop doing this. No, there we go. Oh yeah, that was the right thing. Yeah, he ran away, he knows. Okay. Some kind of semblance of tidiness, but I just don't care at the moment. Okay. So we're going to run this thing over here. And I'm going to see if we're even getting close to having the crystal arrive. Like, I don't know if I actually... I think I gave the crystal miners power, and they should be powered. So that's the dream. Now, what we'll do is part of my big project is to move all storage to my centralized storage location. And I'm going to definitely do that. But for now, maybe I should just move my crystal into a storage container down here and then move it. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'm just going to put a storage container right here and have the crystal go in here just for the temporarily while I'm trying to get things situated. So I'm going to just kind of hook it up to the conveyor belt here, or pray that that's hooked up. That was my goal anyway. I used a control click and it worked. Invalid shape. Fiddle-dee-dee. It does not. Don't tell me that. It's telling me that. Okay, fine. So I tried to use control click. I tried to make that happen. It looks like it wants to happen. And then it's like, no, it's not happening. So let's try this again. Let's pretend. All right. Come on now. Come on. Work with me. There you go. And lead it in there. We did it. All right, great. Okay, so let's go back, and I'm going to go try to get one of my tractors, and I'm going to pick some mushrooms so I can get the technology going for mushrooms. We're not there yet. I just picked those leaves, by the way, to get them out of my way. My bag space is actually getting pressed. I need to be a little bit more careful about what I carry around, but this is fine for the time being. All right, so let's see. Oh my god, here it comes. Look, it is coming. You'll see it in just about 1 second, I think, as it emerges. So this is, it'll come through this dirt here, I think, at some point. Yep, this is crystal. Crystal quartz. All right, so this is working. That is tremendous. Okay. So given that, right, and we're having this all kind of feed into this storage box, I need to make some kind of processing facility for crystal. Oh, there's a bad guy just walking on my conveyor belt. That's absolutely a no. I somehow didn't hit him. Got him. Now he's gone. Look, buddy. Oh, it's called Hog Remains. Interesting. Alright. Anyway. Crystal's coming in, right? And so this crystal is going to this. And now what we need to build would be something to process crystal. And I don't think that it's done in a smelter. Or a foundry, really. Maybe it is. Let's see. Crystal. No, I would need the name of the facility. Let me look at a smelter and see what it can do there. For example, here's a smelter. And what can you do? Nah, you can't do it. Alright, let's look at how we process that. Maybe it's a tech tree. Let me look on the MAM. What? Is there a bad guy in my base? Oh my god, there is. Get out of here. Come on, man. That's not where you belong. Alright, let's check the MAM. And let me just check on the, quartz. So, I need a crystal oscillator. Ah, but I just need crystal to do that, and I don't have it yet. So I think this is what I use to process it, right? So we'll get that going. And then we can make, you know, these other things. Or a little car or something. Which is exciting. Okay. So let's finish the crystal operation by just getting a bunch of crystal and starting the research projects with MAM. Alright. Oh, and let me also just go over here. I got some great feedback on YouTube about this. And I'm going to do this. Optimize older operations. So, oh, I didn't save it. That's a shame. Let me try this again. What I want to do is just look at some of my older operations and fix them by just changing the capacity of the conveyor belt, the amount that we're smelting, and try to fully optimize what I've already built. Because from what I understand from some kind YouTube commenters, I am only running about like 1/5 or 1/10 of what I'm capable of given my facility, because of how mismanaged everything is on my end. So there you go. I don't think I need to carry around all these sheets, but sometimes they're helpful. All right, so here comes the crystal. Right. So anyway, we need to wait for this to fill up a bit. While we're waiting for that, let's work on operation number two. And operation number two is getting these storage containers hooked up to other installations so we don't have them getting filled up. So for the time being, let me just say, I'll take all of these screws, right? So there's screws that are being made here, and this is almost even full. And I've always been interested in what happens when you do this, but I'm going to take an out from this particular container, and I need to put it in there, okay? And there it goes. And then my idea is, does the storage container automatically ship stuff out, or does it only ship stuff out when it's full? So that will be one question. Now, another question is, what if I go in here and I just say, hey, you know, can I build a better storage container? Let's see. The industrial storage container, right. Like, could I build this here? Now, I don't have the item for this. Like, I can pin it, but I don't have steel beams or enough of them on me. I am making steel beams, though, I think, somewhere. Actually, let me look. I think one of these is steel beams. This, let's look down here. Steel pipes, baby. Steel beams. Yeah, look, steel beams. Oh, God, I have a bunch. Okay, terrific. So then what I can do is I want to actually make these industrial storage. So let me just go industrial storage, and can I just build it on top of what exists? Can I, like, change this into industrial storage? I don't know if I can. I don't know if I can rightly upgrade this without destroying it, unfortunately. I was hoping, like, if I clicked on this and I just, you know, clicked where it existed, I could just upgrade this, but it doesn't look like that's a thing. So I'm going to go ahead and dismantle this, and then we're going to just build an industrial storage here instead. I'm going to need to pick this up. I can't fit them. And I'm getting steel beams in here. Why am I getting steel beams? Oh, that's just what it costs to build the thing. Okay, I gotcha. Well, for the time being, what I'm going to do is just kind of put all the steel beams in there and all my concrete in there and all my wire in there so I can pick all this stuff up. And then what I'll do is I'm going to build an industrial storage right there, in kind of in line with what we've been building. But I need to turn it around, obviously, so that its input is over there. That's correct. And I want it to look just like this other guy. But here, let me line this up. No, I want it to go down. Actually, this is fine. I'm fine with that. All right, so let's see what this looks like. So now we've built it, and it's right here. Oh, it's got two stories. And so you can have, what, two outputs? And then maybe you can program them or something? I don't know. But what I do know is I'm trying to connect this to my screws. So I can have screws coming in to one location. There we go. And then this will allow me, hopefully... Yep, it's double the size, and this is going to be our screws. So what we'll then do is we're going to build, you know, one of these signs. Is that the size that we had before? Looks like it, right? So let me put this on here, and then let me configure this, and it's going to have an icon of screws. And we're going to say select that image, and we're going to select the text, and it's going to say so many screws. Okay? And then we're going to say fantastic. We're going to close that, and it's going to have screws. And then this whole thing will be screws eventually. They'll just all come in here. Okay, great. Now, I'm going to try to take everything from inside here. I can't. I need to dump in some of these screws. Well, actually, let me dump in this one and keep this. And then I'm going to go down to this. There's some stuff that I don't need to be carrying, I feel like. Yeah, I don't need this many rods. I mean, I need some, but not quite that many. All right, this is empty. Okay. And then what we can do is we can just destroy this. And we're going to... we're going to copy this by using the middle mouse button. And then we're going to build another one right next door. And we're going to have it oriented the exact same way. I'm going to just, yep, put it there. And be really thrilled with that result. Now, speaking of rods, I need rods. Like, rods have to go in there. So let's do that. Oh, you know what we need, though? God, our concrete keeps getting backed up. The caterium is just out of control. Okay. So, let me take as much caterium as I can fit. And then... go over here. This is even out of control. My God. All right. All right. So, the way I see this game scaling up, I'm never going to not need a ton of stuff. So, I always want things to be getting gathered. So let me make this, I'm going to make this concrete, actually, because I see an immediate problem right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build, actually, no, let's do it the right way. Let me just go ahead and duplicate that, build it here. Now you could, I suppose, like, have some on the top and on the bottom, but I'm going to have so many that I need it to be like this. All right, concrete. Baby. Uh-huh. And we're going to just close it. There we go. And from this, I'm going to take my concrete line. Like, what's in here? Everything comes in here eventually. Okay. Do I have... I have a separate concrete line somewhere. Maybe I don't. Oh God, that's going to be troublesome. I do from another place, but for over here, it's caterium that's the singular issue. So how am I going to sort this out? I'm going to need to use some sorting technology. I know I have some things that sort of do that, like the smart merger and splitter, but maybe not. Like, this is getting me so much... caterium, it's ridiculous. So then let's build a caterium thing, because I just can't, I can't hold all this. Alright. Let me go ahead and Let me deposit rods and concrete for now. And then try to pick this up. Can I pick this up? Can I take it all? Almost. Put the rods in there. Okay. Alright. Then, what I'm gonna do... I don't even know if I need raw caterium, to be honest. I really just need it to be made into quickwire. So maybe instead of even storing it, what I should do is just have the quickwire or the caterium go directly to my operation here. Yeah, I should. Let's do that. Let me just grab all the caterium and let me find where it merges in with this line and just break it apart. I think this is going to be more complicated than I originally thought. It's okay, though. I need better technology. I need, like, the smart splitter. Here we go. So, high-speed connector, power switch, supercomputer, smart splitter. This is what we need. So, we need 10 of these AI limiters to be built. So, I need to start building these. But I don't know exactly how to do that. So let me go into, is it something that you build at the assembler or a constructor? Let's check. So many jobs getting added. All right, so what is this? This is an awesome sink. Right. That's fine. This is my assembler. What can you make? You can make AI limiters. Great. And right now, you're currently making bolted iron plates, but you're out of screws. Okay. Well, I just looked at my screw situation. Eventually, this will all get sorted out and taken care of. I won't need to be moving screws from place to place, but we're not quite there yet, unfortunately. All right, let me go here, and let me just, like, take as many screws as I can carry. Also, I've got to have some stuff I can offload that I don't need to be carrying. Like, okay, yeah, for example, this thing, put it in the box. These alien remains, put it in the box. Put flower petals in the box. These alien remains. What is all this? I have a bunch of coal I'm just carrying around. Yeah, we don't need that for the time being. Okay, so give me some more screws. And let me just go dump these over here. We have enough crystal now to start researching. Oh boy. Here comes me getting blown away by the amount of stuff that I have to do in this. Okay, so... deposit all that, give me one back, and then there you go. Now this should start going again. Now, do I have a assembler that's just chilling? Sometimes I have one of these, like, just an assembler on the fly for quick operations that I need. I used to. Maybe I destroyed that. What is this? This is a constructor, and the constructor is, like, biomass making. Do I need anything else right now? Silica. Okay, so this is what we would do. We'd need to make silica. Okay. And apparently we need to make, protein. Oh, that meat looks awful. Power shards. Okay, so we could make some power shards to change the output of things. Overclock things. Interesting. I'm going to need to start breaking down my crystal into silica. So let me go over to the crystal, by the way, and pick it up. And it's over here. So how are we doing? Do we have enough now? Yeah, we have enough. All right. So I can use this in the MAM to start doing some research. And then what I can do is just build a constructor, like right over here. And just kind of hook up my crystal. And then from this, we just kind of take a line to here. Over to our new... What, did this automatically hook up to something? No. There we go. I was like, what's going on? Okay, there we go. And then from here, we want silica. And here it comes. All right, so our production rate is 37.5 per minute. And we can change this with power shards to change the production rate. Right. So right now we're getting 3 raw quartz and we're getting 22.5 per minute. I don't know why this is idle. Am I not giving you raw quartz? What is this? Oh, these are not raw quartz. These are quartz crystal. Do I need to be doing something different with this? Oh. No, I already processed these, didn't I? So this is something else. Whoops. Okay, well. So instead, I actually need to be breaking apart my... I need to be making silica instead of just quartz crystal. So that's very interesting. I was not on the ball with that. I need to go do that and probably way back at my extraction point. All right. So I should be sending back... I have 2 crystal mines, so I should be sending back one that is silica and one that is the crystal. Holy smokes, I've got a lot going on here. All right, so, oops, wrong button. Let me just configure this, and let's go to quartz, and let's do this. And we say start research. And now we can make a crystal oscillator. Fantastic, and over here, we could do this if we had enough bullets, and we can do this, but we don't have enough crystal oscillators, and we could do this, but we don't have the frames. And we can make a radio signal scanning, but we don't have the oscillators. And this is a radar technology. Huh. That's hilarious. Okay. I want to build this car, but I heard that you need crude oil for that, which I don't have that. Okay. So in the meantime, let me run over here. And what are you doing, assembler? You're trying to make... rotors, but you're out of screws. Fair enough. Alright. So let's just fill this with screws. As we're on operation, be a gopher and keep things going for now until I get this more efficiently optimized. Okay. Now, you have coal coming in. I'm just going to give you a bunch of more coal because I have coal on me. And I know you won't use this for, you know, quite some time, but I don't want to carry this coal around. So here's where we're at. What? Oh, this is the foundry. That's right. Okay, right. I'm like, what's going on? All right. No, I get it now. I can't give you any more, but I tried. How's it going in here? Looks great. Alright, fantastic. Okay, so crystal mining is doing better, but I need some serious readjustments to my flagship operation. I'm going to put all my coal away. We're going to sort this up. We have a lot of space, which is looking good. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to go then over to my crystal and try to at least finish this first task. Anything I want to buy with coupons? I mean, this factory cart does look pretty good. Alright, so let's go. What do you have? Sheets? Oh god, you're about to run out. What do you got? Bars? You've got rods? Dear lord. Do you have them? Okay. Let me actually do this, because this is going to fill up and it's going to back up my production. So what I got to do is run this all the way over. Here. And then put this in, you know, some kind of home. I can actually just put it on this side. I don't have to have them all on one side. So what we'll do is we'll build ourselves a industrial storage container right here. And I'm going to, let's see, have it all the way at the edge. Right there. Perfect. And then let me just see if I can, I might have to redo this, but no, it worked. Okay, there we go. And then this will be, you know, rods. And we'll just select a new image, which looks like that. And we will call it Iron Rods, baby. And then we'll just close that. And then this should start getting filled up with iron rods, and it will. All right, terrific. Okay, so for the time being, I'm going to destroy this ramp as well. Goodbye. And I figure I need some silica. I don't know what the ratio is, but half and half at the time being, you know, it sounds fine. All right. And where's my goo? It's over here. Let me try to land in my goo. Yep. I made it. All right, and let's go. Having a faster transport, like a little racing car, sounds awesome. Right now I've got my tractor. It's far away, but we'll get it. While I'm here, I'll also get the mushrooms. Someone is trying to kill me. I'm running past them. I also heard that you can chainsaw the mushrooms. So, for example, given that, if I found a cave, like the cave that I found back there, I could just use that and chainsaw the big mushrooms and get what I need, I believe, but I'm not 100% on that. Yep, this is where we're making it. So I can actually just interrupt the flow of this right here, right? Oh, come on now. Don't be a jerk. Oh, there's so many of them, too. They're all being jerks. I need to make the better bullets just so I can talk to these guys. Come on. Come on. The enemies definitely behave differently. This guy has a little bit more health than before. And he's running away. So you can just kind of scare them away without actually murdering them. Uh-oh, somebody's coming. Alright. Please don't fight me. You don't want it. Did you get stuck? Yeah. Alright, get out of the way. Okay. So anyway, let me just duplicate this, and we're going to build another one. Right there. And then all we have to do is connect this to my power pole. Oh, not that button. That button. And then we go to logistics. And we're going to have some fun. So we're going to split this. All right. And then we're going to run this to there. And now we're going to configure this, oops, to make silica. Okay. That's correct. And then we're going to build a merger. Nope, not that. A merger back over here. And we'll just aim it at this until we get it right. That's correct. And then we will sync that. And here it comes. Silica. All right, so we got silica, and I'm happy with the crystal mining operation now. So let me go over here, and let me just adjust my orders. And crystal mining is done. So I'm just going to take this off the list. And now we got to get the mushrooms in the cave. So I want to check out, somebody gave me this tip to try using the chainsaw, and I'm super stoked to do that, so I will. Don't try to shoot me with that fireball. You're going to regret it. We'll all regret it, is I guess what I mean to say about that. And let's see. Is there a cave back here? Nah. But I know that there's a cave over here. Did I mark it on my map? No. No, I didn't. But I could have. And it would have been smart. I'm trying this cave because I want to see if there's a closer location for me to get mushrooms than running all the way over there. Although it would allow me to get a tractor back, but I'm not that married to the tractor. All right, let's check this out. Let's see if this little cave that we found oh so long ago that scared... Here we go. Here's the mushroom. Look, buddy, you can run. I mean, you're going to stay there? Okay. Well, then no, you can't run. Sorry. Anyway. I'm going to switch to my chainsaw. And I'm going to be like, hey, mushroom man. Oh, God. You guys were so right. Yes. I got 11 mycelia right there. Beautiful. Let's get it. All right, this is amazing. Yes, look at how much mushroom we're getting. Beautiful. I don't know if these things grow back. And what are you? Can I get you? Nah, I can't really, like, attack you with this. You're more of a decorative piece. That's fine. What about you? Not really. No. Can't pick you up with my hand. Can't chop you with my chainsaw. These are leaves. Meh. Oh, God. No. Get away from... get out of that. Okay. Alright. Okay. Let's just take our mushrooms and go. I'm gonna mark this on the map, though. I'm gonna push map. And we're going to be like, hey, uh-oh, somebody's coming. Wait a minute, what's that noise? Where's the bad guy? You're never safe. You never know. All right, and so what we're going to do is I'm going to go back to the map, and I'm going to mark it with, like, you know, a little symbol for myself. I guess this is fine. I'll put it right here. New map marker right there. And, oh, okay, select icon. Oh, this is even better. I don't know what it would be. Stamps, maybe? Yeah, plant. Okay, select image. And select color. We'll go ahead and get a blue color on here. More blue than that. Yeah, there you go. And we're going to call it... Mushroom Cave. And apply. Okay. So, I'm going to run away. I'm going to go to the mayhem. And we're going to just jump up, hopefully avoid all shenanigans. I'm going to check the map, see if my mushroom... Yep, my mushroom marker is there. This new map in version 6 is just absolutely fantastic. Okay, and then what we'll do is move over here. And I'm just going to jump in and attempt to go to the mayhem and solve some problems. All right, this would be under mycelia. And so now I can maybe do fabric. If I have enough, I do. Okay, and then now with fabric, we can like get an expanded tool belt, for example. We can get this, but we don't have whatever that is. Oh, a parachute. That looks like a lot of fun. But we would need to actually make fabric, which we haven't done yet. All right, cool. So now then, we will push tab and we will alter our goals. And we did this, so now it's like a question of we need to get a sulfur operation up. Okay, we need to move our storage and we need to make fabric as well. Cool. Well, everyone, we're doing well. It's a slow progress. It's a slow arc as we try to make sense of all the stuff that we've got going on here, but we're doing pretty decently. I have a lot of optimization to figure out. I need to get my storage set. I need to get sulfur happening. I need to make the fabric, but we now have our crystal so that we're at least getting silica and crystal, and we started putting some industrial storage in for some of these bigger pieces, and I'm happy about it. Everyone, I want to thank you so much for watching. I hope you have an excellent evening or day, and I'll check you guys next time. Take care.